Welcome to another edition of 2 Minutes to Launch. My name is Terry, and today I'll be talking about financial mistakes that hardware startups make. Now, as many as 80 to 90% of hardware startups fail, and I'm going to talk about a few of the reasons why today. First, just in terms of your general fundraising effort to get you all the way to production, quite often what we see is companies not raising enough funds, whether this comes from overly optimistic projections of saying, well, if everything goes perfectly, we're only going to need this much money to get to production. Other times it might be from just a lack of experience, really not knowing what you need money for or how much you might need that's unexpected. Other times it's from a successful crowdfunding campaign that's raised a certain amount of money that feels like it should be enough to get there. In any case, only having enough funds to get 60, 70, 80% of the way through the new product introduction phase is a recipe for disaster and is where many hardware startups fail. So my recommendation here is making sure you're working with investors and advisors and partners that really know hardware that can help make sure that you're setting the proper fundraising goals and expectations to get you all the way to production. Second, in terms of the product cost itself, in manufacturing, they say you can have speed, quality, and cost, but you can only pick two of them. A lot of hardware startups focus on speed and quality because they have to get something done quickly, and it's got to work reliably. And the assumption is, well, we can cost reduce later. Quite often, that cost reduction effort, in order to be significant, really can be time consuming and expensive to get there. It's much more involved than just swapping out a couple of cheaper components. So my recommendation in this phase as you focus on the product cost itself is to make sure you're designing for cost up front. Even if it takes a little bit longer early, it's going to pay dividends down the road. And lastly, as a startup, you're likely not going to get a credit line from your manufacturing partner. So really planning for the costs of ramping up production is really, really important. So you're probably going to be required to put down some deposit against components or production even before materials are ordered. And then when you throw in the lead time for materials, the lead time for production, you're already cash out for quite a long time. And on the flip side, your customers are going to expect from the time they received finished goods that they're not going to pay you for at least 30 or 60 or 90 days. So the recommendation here is making sure you're planning for a really long cash cycle, especially on these initial production units, is really, really important, especially for a startup. Thanks for watching. That's been 2 Minutes to Launch for today. Please follow SEACOMP on LinkedIn and leave your questions in the comments below, and we'll make sure to get to them.